Poem Postcard from Kashmir. The speaker describes receiving a postcard from his native land, Kashmir. That is a region of the Indian subcontinent. Parts of Kashmir are controlled by India, Pakistan, and China. And in fact, disputes between India and Pakistan about the territory are long-standing and have often led to armed conflict. The speaker in the poem describes his feelings after receiving a postcard from his native land, Kashmir. The postcard contains a photograph of Kashmir, that is a place the speaker still considers his home. When he receives that postcard, he says, the poem begins as, Kashmir shrinks into my mailbox, my home a neat 4 by 6 inches. The opening 2 lines of the poem indicates that the postcard contains a photograph of Kashmir. That is a place the speaker still considers his home. Apparently, he is geographically distant from Kashmir, a fact that makes his use of the word home ironic. He may have been born in Kashmir and may have lived there for much of his life, but now he is apparently living somewhere else, perhaps even in some Western country such as United Kingdom or the United States. So when he called my home for that picture of Kashmir, it seems ironic. The word shrinks in the line, Kashmir shrinks into my mailbox, suggests that the real grandeur Kashmir diminishes to the tiny delicate picture printed on the postcard. The word home in line number 2, normal speaking refers to a place where people are currently living in. Postcards are usually sent from a place people spend their holidays on. But here the poet receives a postcard from his home, Kashmir. Apparently, the speaker has lost touch with his homeland. The 4 by 6 inch postcard simply evokes his memories towards his birthplace. I always loved neatness. Now I hold the 1/2 inch Himalayas in my hand. This 4 by 6 inch photograph is looked at with love by the speaker, who is geographically distant from Kashmir and lives in one of the Western countries. The speaker claims that he always loved neatness. It read, that was typical of Kashmir of his childhood days. But the irony of the fact is expressed by his claim that he holds the 1/2 inch Himalayas in his hand now. The massive mountain range has been reduced to a small, tidy picture, which is surely not the kind of neatness the speaker truly desires. One of the most impressive aspects of his homeland has thus been shrunken and made to seem far less impressive and significant. Although the speaker holds the postcard, he has in more literal ways lost touch with the land he loves. The poet highlights that he always loved neatness. The adjective neat refers not only to the regular shape of the postcard, but also the neat and harmonious Kashmir in the poet's memory. In line number 3, the use of the past tense for the first and only time in the poem shows that war-torn Kashmir is no longer as calm and peaceful as it used to be. The speaker then switches his focus to the mere 1/2 inch Himalayas, which is in reality the most gigantic and iconic mountain range in the world. The poet deliberately uses the same kind of contrast to express the wide distance between Kashmir and where he is at present. The alliteration is used in the words hold, 1/2 inch, Himalayas, and hand. This is home, and this the closest I will ever be to home. The tone of the poem is getting increasingly serious and emotional from this line. This is home, and this is the closest I will ever be to home. When he says this is home, does he mean the unnamed place where he currently resides, which seems a poor substitute for his actual home of Kashmir? The phrasing of line 5 and 6 is not entirely clear, and it contributes an interesting ambiguity to the poem. A powerful rhetorical repetition of home emphasizes poet's deep affection towards the land he loves. Irony, the word closest. It is saddening to know that the poet yearns to be home, but the chance to do so is very rare. The most ambiguous line of the poem is "This is home," which either can mean the poet's inability to leave the place where he lives and has compromised it for his homeland. It is clear that the ultimate aim of the poem is to express the poet's unbounded patriotic love to Kashmir, the place he is proud to call his home. When I return, the colors won't be so brilliant, the Jhelum's water so clean, so ultramarine, my love so overexposed. The poet continues to build up a bitter mood by imagining what Kashmir will be like when he returns. The speaker assumes that when he does actually return to Kashmir, in reality, not in imagination, the real sights of the place will not live up neither to the picture of them presented in the postcard nor to the idealized memory of them in the speaker's mind. Torn by wars, Kashmir would not be so colorful. Bloodshed Jhelum's water would not be so clean and ultramarine anymore. His emotion reaches the climax at my love so overexposed. The poet intentionally separates so overexposed from my love in order to achieve a rhetorical emphasis on his patriotic sentiments. Overexposed show how overwhelming the poet's nostalgic love to Kashmir is in a somehow distorted and explicit manner, just like a piece of photography that are overexposed, means too much light. The repeated use of so in line 7 to 10 intensifies the poet's pity and lament for the destruction of Kashmir. And my memory will be a little out of focus, in it a giant negative, black and white, still undeveloped. In the poem's closing lines, the speaker suggests that his memory of Kashmir is unreliable and that Kashmir itself may be like a giant negative, black and white, still undeveloped. These lines, especially the last words, are suggestive. They may imply that Kashmir is still in the process of development as a place, that it is at present still too polarized to live up either to the speaker's idealized memory of it or to the postcard's idealized presentation of its beauty. The last sentence of the poem is filled with quite a number of commas. This structure reflects that memories are just pieces of flashbacks and feelings that tangle together. However enchanting his memories are, they are indeed messy and will gradually fade. Giant and negative, the two adjectives. These adjectives help contrast the shrunken, idealized Kashmir in the postcard with the giant, grim one in reality. Black and white, a metonym for things happened in the past, it contrasts the stark color on the postcard. On a final note, we should pay attention to the number of lines in this poem. The number of lines are 14, but they are written in free verse. These 14 lines are identical to that of Shakespearean sonnets, a traditional format for love poems. It is glaringly clear that the ultimate aim of the poem is to channel the poet's unbounded patriotic love to Kashmir, the place he proud to call it home. Kashmir is the most inflammable part between the India and Pakistan. Due to the dispute, many native people of the region migrated from that place. Kashmir is the heaven of the earth. Still, they are away from their homeland. Through this poem, poet tries to focus on the sentiment of people of Kashmir. Nostalgia for the motherland is the central theme of this poem, and poet is seeking the quest for identity. Thank you.